This trick is called Psychic Location and it's by Bob King, and I really like this effect, and I'm going to start off by giving the cards a bit of a mix up. Like so. I'm also going to give the cards a cut in. I'm going to show you, the spectator, the cards are nicely mixed up and in no particular order, and also offer the cards to you to give them a cut. You might want to give them a triple cut as well. Now I'm going to spread the cards, and I want you to point to a card. So I'm going to spread the cards out. So I have to point to this card here. I'm just going to place this card down on the table. Now at this point you turn your back. So while I've got my back turned, I just want you to have a look at this card. So I turn the card on and have a look at it. So I want you to remember that card, put that card to memory. Now while I've still got my back turned, I want you to flip the card over, drop the deck on top and cut your card into the deck. Cut the card as many times as you like till you're completely happy that your card is completely and well and truly lost in this deck, okay? So I don't know exactly where you've cut the card. Now they can carry on cutting so they're completely happy that their card is lost somewhere in this deck, okay? Now, while you've still got your back turned, you say to them, I want you to have a look at this top card. So they turn over the top card and then have a look at it, and you say, is that your card? And they're saying no. You say, but is it the same colour as your card? And they're saying no. Okay? So you'd ask them to turn the next card over. So turn this next card on, you still got your back turned now, and you say, is either one of these cards the same suit as your card? And they say yes. Okay, you'd ask them to drop these two cards back on top of the deck like so. Now you could turn back round at this point and you'd say to them, I want you to think of your card and I'll try and pick up on your thoughts, and I'm going to see if I can find out whereabouts is in this deck based on the answers to the questions I gave you. Okay, now does the number 30 mean anything to you? And they'll probably say no. So, well, what I'm going to do, I'm going to attempt to cut to your card like so. Okay, now I want you to think of your card. Actually, you can tell me your card, okay? And let's say whatever card it was, the six of diamonds, okay? So I'm going to count these cards down onto the table, and you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 cards there. Okay? And this is the card I cut to. Now I want you to turn over and have a look at this card. But before you do, would this be totally amazing if that's your chosen card in the 30th position I got predicted? And it is a six of diamonds. Let's just have a look. And they turn the card over, it could be the six of diamonds. Now I hope you really enjoyed this, and thank you very much for watching.